Hey, howdy guys, Connor McCaskill here at a very smoky Etiwanda. Like, you can't barely see the mountains over there. It's really unfortunate, it smells like smoke, so I'm definitely not gonna actually hike this trail. I don't think that it's healthy to be breathing in smoke while you're kind of exerting yourself hiking, so I apologize. This is pretty much just gonna be my environment for this video. But that being said, I wanna talk about the Fujifilm X-T5. Now, obviously the Fujifilm X-T5, why would I wanna talk about that? Because it seems a little early. The Fujifilm X-T4 just literally came out. I think it shipped in April or something like that. So yeah, maybe it's a little early, but I don't know, I like the dream. I wanna dream about what the Fujifilm X-T5 could be and almost kind of predict it and see if I'm right when it is finally announced, probably next year. So this is just going to be a list of the top five things that I really want to see in a Fujifilm X-T5, something that's deserving of the new number. I do think that the X-T4 should have been called the X-T3S because we got some basic upgrades with it. But I'm also curious to hear what your guys' five things you would want to be in the X-T5. So definitely leave me a comment down below on the things that you want to see in the Fujifilm X-T5. So without any further ado, let's talk about the Fujifilm X-T5. Okay, so the first thing that I would like to see implemented into the Fujifilm X-T5 is 6K recording. So with the Fujifilm X-T3 and the X-T4, we've actually had 6K sensors in both. So what we're getting is a downsampled 4K, which is nice. It's a high quality 4K, but I would really like to see 6K coming out of these cameras. I feel like a lot of 6K cameras are coming out. We're even seeing 8K to some extent with like the R5. Maybe what they could implement with the Fujifilm X-T5 could be an 8K sensor that is downsampled to 6K recording. That would be really cool. So yeah, I would definitely like to see a slightly higher resolution than 4K in the Fujifilm X-T5. Another thing that would be great to see in the Fujifilm X-T5 would be better body ergonomics than the X-T4. Now, I'm not talking about how the camera itself looks. I actually really love how Fujifilm cameras look and have been looking for a while now, but more what I mean is like the functionality of the camera itself. One thing that I can name in particular with better body ergonomics would definitely be the flip screen. Definitely love the flip screen. However, I would like to see them do something kind of like what they did with the R5 and the R6, where the flip screen, the tilt screen, doesn't get in the way of audio cables. When I try to flip the flip screen, it bonks into the cable. So you have to do like this awkward little turn thing so that it doesn't hit the cable. And then you can flip around the screen. That would be one. Another thing would be a deeper grip. I think the grip on the X-T4 is fine. It's definitely decent, it works. But a slightly deeper grip so you can get a better hold would be nice because the camera is a little bit on the smaller side. So the third thing I'd like to see implemented in the next version of these cameras would be true autofocus tracking. So in the X-T4, we do have face tracking, which works pretty good. I'm using it right now. So if you see it hunt at all, blame the autofocus. But I would like to see object tracking. Something that when I got the X-T4, I almost just for some reason thought it was going to have, and then it didn't. And I was pretty bummed about it. I want it to be kind of like how Canon or Sony works. Like say I'm filming a bird and I want to tap on the screen, touch the bird. Now it's tracking the bird. No matter where the bird moves, it's focused on the bird. That's something I would like to see. Also, while talking about birds, animal eye track is something that's been coming up in cameras lately. And it would be really nice to have that also implemented in the Fujifilm X-T5. So object tracking, animal eye tracking, that's what I would love to see. Now, the fourth thing that I would like to see is raw external recording. I don't necessarily care if it's internal recording with raw. I mean, we've seen raw internal recording with the R5, and obviously that did not go very well. So I don't wanna see that happen with the X-T5, but I would love to see external recording through an Atomos, kind of like what Sony's doing, when they're getting 16-bit raw, I believe, out of the A7S III. Or the Nikon Z6, which I think pioneered RAW out through HDMI. So being able to do HDMI out, raw recording in 4K, 6K, doesn't really matter. I think that would be really cool. I would love to see Fujifilm raw. That would be something really interesting and fun to play around with. Now, in order to do raw, they might have to go with a bigger HDMI port. They are only doing a micro HDMI right now, which I don't think anybody likes micro HDMI. So maybe along with the body ergonomics that I was talking about earlier, be nice to see HDMI mini or maybe even a full HDMI. It's definitely possible because the A7S III is kind of a smaller body camera. They managed to squeeze in a full HDMI. So full HDMI, X-T5, raw external recording, that'd be awesome. And the fifth thing that I want to see in the Fujifilm X-T5, and I definitely think I'm dreaming a bit on this one, I would love to see full frame. I know like the whole debate like full frame versus crop sensor, it doesn't really matter. Well, to some extent you're right, because at the end of the day I love the image coming out of my X-T4. But for me personally, I do think that I enjoy the full frame look over a crop sensor look. And that just comes down to personal preference. I believe Fujifilm has said that they are not gonna do a full frame camera. And when asked why, they basically said, well, because we have a really good APS-C camera, which they do. And they also have a really good medium format camera with GFX 100, and they didn't see a need to make a full frame camera. I don't know, that sounds like BS to me. I think the real reason why they don't want to make a full frame camera is because that would require a new mount and a whole new line of lenses. And I don't think that they want to make full frame lenses when they have a huge history of APS-C and medium format lenses. So definitely dreaming, but full frame Fujifilm, I mean, come on, that'd be really cool. Okay, so that's it. That's my list. The five things that I personally would love to see in a Fujifilm X-T5. I would be very interested to hear what your guys' top five things that you want to see in the X-T5 would be. So drop me a comment down below and rank them from what you want the most to maybe what you want the least amount, but still, top five things that you guys want to see in a Fujifilm X-T5. Also, a little bit of an update for anyone who cares. I've started a little gaming Twitch. So if anyone out there is a gamer bro or a gamer gal and they want to hang out with me and my friends playing some Warzone and maybe a few other games, definitely check out my Twitch, twitch.tv/ConnorMcCaskill. Having some fun there. But anyways, I hope you all have a fantastic week. Stay safe out there, guys. And as always, thanks for hanging.
Whole team behind that counter. Load, come on.
That's awesome.